So ready for the next sum? Here is your next question. The next question says, find the value of 27 divided by 3 into 8. Okay, and your options are A24, B27, C42, and D72. Okay, so now here they have given us two operations to perform. First we will divide, and then whatever answer we will obtain here, with that answer we need to multiply by 8. Okay, so first one we will do the division. So 27 divided by 3. So 3 into 9 is 27. So which means that now 9 into 8. So 9 8s are 72. So where can you find 72, children? Yes, option D. So option D is my right answer. Got it? So first we have done the division part. After that, from the answer which we have obtained, we have multiplied into 8 to get the final answer. Clear? Shall we move the next one? Okay. So here is your next question. The next question says, how many 8s are there? How many 8s are there in 120? Okay, and your options are 12, option B, 15, option C, 40, and option D, 41. So did you understand this question? We need to find out how many 8s are there in this number. Fine. We will just divide it and see. So 120 divided by 8. So 8 ones are 8. So here 12 minus 8, 4, 0. 15. So 8 fives are 40. So my answer is 15. So how many 8s are there in 120, children? It is option B, 15. Got it? Shall we move to the next one? Here is your next question. The next question says, which of the following should replace 'hash' so that (0, *18) is equals to 0 is correct? And the options are plus or minus, option B, into or division, option C, into or plus, option D, plus or division. So did you understand here, children? So we need to find that what can be replaced. So in case if I do whichever operation I do with 0, I should get the answer as 0. So we will try recollecting the properties of all the 4 which we have learned. Coming to the addition, anything added with 0 will be the number itself. So which means the addition will not work out here, because I need to get the answer as 0. Right? Similarly, coming to the subtraction property. Anything subtracted from 0 will be the number itself. Again, it doesn't fall correct here. So, which means option A is ruled out. Yes. Next, coming to the option B. We will try to revive the property of multiplication. Anything multiplied by 0 will be 0. So, which means multiplication will stand correct. Coming to the division, anything divided by 0 will be 0. So, which means option B is the right one. So, here this asterisk can be replaced with a into sign or a division sign, which will give me the answer 0. Clear, children? Shall we move to the next one? Here is your next question. The next question says, 5 children share 139 blue beads and 196 red beads equally. How many beads does each child get? My options are option A 607, option B 67, option C 13, and option D 76. Okay, so now they say that 5 children share 139 blue beads and 196 red beads equally. So it means that they have just given this extra information to confuse us. So what we have to do is, first we need to add the total of blue and the red beads. Whatever is the total amount of beads which we obtain, that we need to divide by 5. Okay. So first 139 plus 196. So 9 plus 6, 15. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 9, 13. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So, which means I have the total beads as 335. Okay. So, now this 335 beads I will be dividing equally among 5 children. So, 335 divided by 5. So, 5, 6 are 30. And 5 sevens are 35. So, which means my answer is 67. Where is 67, children? Yes. Option B, 67 is the right answer. Got it? So, this information, the splitting of information is just given to confuse us. Okay? So, did you understand this question? Shall we move ahead, children?